In addition to the class, Java has a construct called the interface. Interface C1 is shown to the right. Instead of keyword class, use interface. The components of the class must be public abstract methods, as shown. We mentioned two other possibilities in a later video. So an interface looks a lot like an abstract class, all of whose components are abstract methods. You can think of it that way. Since the methods must be public and abstract, those keywords can be omitted, as you see in the declaration of interface C2. Having written interfaces C1 and C2, we can write a class A that implements them, using keyword implements instead of extends. Here are two rules. If a class implements an interface, it must declare or override all methods that are declared in the interface. You can see that class A declares all the methods of C1 and C2. A class can implement more than one interface. Method M appears in both interfaces. There is no ambiguity because no implementation of the method is given in the interfaces, only the syntax. We cannot create an instance of an interface, but we can assign a class A object to a C1 variable. C1 can be used as a type. Thus, T can contain a pointer to an A object. From T's perspective, the only methods that can be called are those declared in interface C1 or superclass object. More on this later. An interface can extend another interface, but use keyword extends, not implements. A class that implements C3 must declare all methods that are in both C3 and C1. We've shown you what an interface is and how one uses it. We haven't yet given you really good examples of its use. That will come. Be patient.